You're the God of this city. You're the King of these people. You're the Lord of this nation. You are. You're the light in this darkness. You're the hope to the hopeless. You're the peace to the restless. You are. There is no one like our God. There is no one like our God. For greater things have yet to come, and greater things are still to be done in this city. Greater things have yet to come, and greater things are still to be done in this city.
And we just we're going to sing this song to start off. It's called Alive, Alive, Alive Forevermore. I would like to just greet everybody in church, our pastors, Pastor Cleveland and Pastor Poseda Perkins, and all the ministers, our moderator for today, Maxine. And I would like, and all the members and visitors, and everyone that's visiting online, welcome in the mighty name of Jesus. And we're still celebrating in this period, resurrection period. And we're going to sing this song called Alive, Alive, Alive Forevermore. Praise God.
Alive, alive, forevermore, my Jesus is alive.
rejoice in God's house today. So I'm going to count you in. 1, 2, 3. Hallelujah. 1, 2, 3. Hallelujah. That's 2. 1, 2, 3. Hallelujah. 1, 2, 3. Hallelujah. 1, 2, 3. Hallelujah. Again. Hallelujah. And one more. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sing hallelujah. My Jesus is alive forevermore. Sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah. My Jesus is alive.
One more time.
Alive, alive, alive forevermore. My Jesus is alive, alive forevermore. Alive, alive, alive forevermore. My Jesus is alive.
Sing hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah. My Jesus. Psalms 13:34, I think. No, actually, it's John 13:34. It says, "A new command I give to you, love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another." What a great love. And we celebrated last week God's Jesus coming, dying, rising again on our behalf because he loves us. And because he did such a great love, he's commanding us. He's not even just asking us. Yeah. It's a command, imperative verb, love one another. Imperative means you must love one another as I have loved you. That's so I just want us to all come to the altar. Feel free. Okay, we're just going to pray and ask God to help us. Not only for the service, but to help us to love one another. Because sometimes it's not easy to love all the time and love everybody. Sometimes people can crush your contour, isn't it? They can crush your contour. I'm sure I'm not the only one that somebody has, you know, crushed your contour before. And then you still have to love them. It's not always easy. It's not easy. But God said, Jesus said, "I command you." It is a command. Love one another as I have loved you. Because he doesn't want his love to go to waste. And the sacrifice that he made to go to waste. Let us all just pray. Father God, we just thank you, Lord God. Thank you for this new day. Thank you for our lives that we have seen another week. Father, thank you. You've preserved us. You have loved us. When we're going out, you have loved us. When we were coming back in, you've loved us in our homes, in our places of work, on the streets, on the public transport, in our cars. You have loved us. You have provided for us, Lord God. You have loved on us this week, Lord God. Even when we haven't seen your angels, Lord God, bearing us up in their arms lest we dash our foot against the stone. Lord God, you have loved us. You have provided for us. You have protected us. Lord God, and you even, through Christ Jesus, you shed blood for us. And we want to say thank you for that love this morning. Such a great love.
Hallelujah. We can't compare it to anything else, Lord God. You said while we were yet sinners, you died for us, Lord God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord, for that love. The love that comforts us. The love that dries our tears. The love, Lord God, that makes us feel strong. Hallelujah. We want to say thank you for that love this morning. And as we worship and we praise you, we know that we are not perfect, Lord God, but we're aspiring, Lord Jesus, to walk as Christ walked on the earth. You said we should love one another. Help us, Lord God. Help us when it's difficult to love. Help us to keep your command in the name. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, to keep your commandments, Lord God. You said we should remain in your love. Remain in your love, no matter what, Lord God, because your love covers a multitude of sins. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory be to God. Help us, Lord God. Touch our hearts, touch our minds, touch our spirits, Lord God. Teach us how to love like you loved, Lord God, so that you will be glorified in your church. You will be glorified in our lives. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Teach us how to love. Love forgives, Lord God. Love forgives. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless your name. Father, we thank you for depositing your love, more of your love in our hearts this morning, so that we will be able to keep your commandment, Lord, even when it's hard, even when it's challenging, even when it's painful. Lord, we thank you for your love in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. As you go to your seats, we're just going to sing this song. Let there be love shed among us. Let there be understand. for us. I'm sure all of us have a testimony of an experience of God's love. Do you know what I mean? Can you put your hands up if you've experienced God's love? Hallelujah, some of us. But all of us have actually, because whether we acknowledge the love or not, it's been given. Bless the Lord. And it's waiting for us sometimes to respond. Let's sing this song to you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
How deep the Father. Should give his only
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. It wasn't easy. It couldn't have been easy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Thank you, Lord. If you just spend a few moments, just give God thanks. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Bless your name, Lord. We praise you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your love. Thank you. You paid the ransom, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Bless the Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
First, the kingdom of God in
not just with my words, but with my life. Thank you. Hallelujah.
First, the kingdom of God and his righteousness.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And all things shall be added unto you.
Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Thank you, Lord. His love that lifted us, we used to say in old days, out of the miry clay.
Come on now.
Hallelujah. Because we were dirty, we were messed up.
Thank you, Lord.
And we needed to be rescued.
Yes.
And so he lifted us. Did he lift you?
Amen. Yeah, yeah.
Sure did lift me. Yeah. Glory be to God. He lifted me and I'm glad about it.
Amen.
So we're going to sing Love Lifted Me. When nothing else could help. We'll be right back. Opportunity to welcome all those who have joined us this morning at Sunday service from the social media platforms, and to welcome everyone to service. We have with us a visitor today, and when I call your name, sir, if you could please just stand, just so that we can give you a warm house of bread welcome, nothing more than that. So Joseph Fahi, I think your name is, if you'd like to please stand just so that we... Oh, wonderful. It's lovely to have you here today. God bless you. God bless you. We also have with us in the house, and I haven't seen this young man, you may be seated, sir, for some years now, and it's Jeffrey. And Jeffrey has been coming here. You may have seen him one or two times, but I feel particularly blessed to see you today, Jeffrey. It's lovely to have you in the house this morning. God bless you, sir. So, I have just a little bit of information for the visitors in the house today. So if you need to use any of the facilities we have here, the toilets, there's some toilets at the front of the church, both male and female can use that, and there's some men's toilets, which is downstairs, if you go through these doors on my right. There's water, there's bottled water if you need some water, and there's a nursery through these double doors on the right if you need to use that to take care of your any children, and if there is an emergency that you need to exit through these two doors, either side of me or through the front of the church. Okay, so I have some announcements that I'd like to say today. So the weekly online activities and the afternoon prayer line is Monday to Friday at 1 o'clock. And that is for everyone who is who would like prayer or want someone prayed for. You can join that on the Zoom. The evening prayer is on a Monday, and that's at 8 p.m. Youth Bible studies is every Tuesday, 7:30 to 8:30. Bible studies Thursday, 8 p.m. On Wednesdays, for the next 3 weeks now, there is free line dance classes. Now, I don't know how many of you heard it last week, but I went and a few of us went, and it was fantastic. It was brilliant. We had a wonderful time, and it's again this Wednesday in the lower hall, and it's at 6 o'clock till 7. And I can tell you,
the steps are quite interesting. It helps with the coordination. So if you'd like to join, everyone is welcome to come to that. On Saturday 13th of April is a national worship gathering, and that's going to be at the Ealing Road Church, and it's themed It's Time, and it's co-hosted by Minister Mark Barnett and Minister Joe Sanford, and the speaker for that event will be Pastor Antonio Toussaint. And you need to register on Eventbrite if you'd like to attend. On Friday the 12th of April, there's a domino tournament at the House of Bread. All men are invited to this event. There will be food available, and it will be a fun evening and a great opportunity to fellowship with one another. So all the men, invite a friend, a male friend, who can come along and play dominoes. I will say, though, that I know that there are some women that like to play dominoes. When my mum was alive, my mum used to like dominoes, and she could really play good. She could knock domino. Okay. Tuesday the 16th of April is the Watoto's Children Choir. That's at 7 till 8:30. It's a free concert here at the House of Bread. And I found out from them this week what the African merchandise is that they will have. And they will have items like hoodies, t-shirts, some stuffed toys. They'll have honey and coffee from Uganda and various other items as well. So it will really be great if everyone could come. It's an evangelical mission. And as we know, the words that Pastor has been passing out to us is everyone a soul winner, everyone a minister. So it's an opportunity for us to be able to evangelize on that day as well. It's not just the children who's going to be doing it, but we can also do it as well. So invite your friends and family to that. The National Ladies Retreat is on Friday the 24th to the 26th. I think I said just 26th last week. It's actually a weekend. So it's the 24th to the 26th of May. And that's at the Leonardo Hotel in Leicestershire. And there's a deadline if you want to get the early bird tickets for this, or the prices, I should say. And that's the 14th of April. So that's coming up quite sharply. So if you really want to get the early bird ticket prices for the rooms, you need to do that by the 14th of April. So the cost of a single room is £310, and the cost of a twin double is £270. You can also go on the Church of God of Prophecy website, and you'll be able to find information relating to that there. Church of God of Prophecy UK will be having a fundraising concert, and this will be at the Wembley Church. Sister Karen Nelson has 5 tickets. You still have 5 tickets? Okay, she still has 5 tickets that can be purchased at £10 each to support the fundraising for the choir to go to Orlando, Florida. And it's the Church of God of Prophecy General Assembly. It will be held in July, but they're working up to that. So if you need tickets, you'd like to support this, please do see Sister Karen Nelson, and she'll be able to supply the ticket. Okay, you heard me say last week about the GDPR, General Data Protection. If you would like us to announce your birthday, your anniversary, your milestone birthdays or anniversaries, please do let any of the PR team know, and then we can take that information and then we can process it in the way that we do and do the announcements, because we don't want anyone to feel left out. You're all loved, and we all want you to know that your birthdays and anniversaries are all important. So please do let us know so that we can do that. So moving on to that quite swiftly. We do have quite a few birthdays. April seems to be quite a busy time for births. All right, okay. I'll start with the anniversaries. So on the 9th of April, we have Sister Sasha and Brother Jason McInnes, who will be celebrating 13 years of marriage. So come on, it's gone so quickly. I'd like to call Sister maybe to be like to come and just take the card for them for us. Tell them that we say congratulations and God bless them. May they live to see many more happy years together. Also, we have Sister Kendra and Brother Kelly Matthews, who will be 13th of April. They'll be celebrating 5 years. I know they're not in the house today because they told me, and normally on these milestones, we give them flowers, but I know that they're not in the house because they told me, but we will get them the flowers and the card as soon as we can. Okay, so we come to the birthdays. So on the 8th of April, we have Sister Elaine Reed, who will be celebrating her birthday on the 8th of April. Happy birthday, my dear, when it comes, that's tomorrow, isn't it? Yes, okay. And also on the 8th of April is Sister Gwendolyn Nicholson. And I don't know if she's in the house, I don't think she's here today, but her birthday is also on the 8th of April. We will be celebrating, we're wishing them all a happy birthday. Now we have some milestones. Actually, sorry, one more. Majesty Campbell is celebrating her 10th birthday. Majesty Campbell is celebrating on the 10th of April her birthday as well. Is that correct? Okay. And she'll be? Okay, so it's not a milestone, but we wish her a very happy birthday on the 10th of April and pray that she has a wonderful day. I'm sure you will have a wonderful day. Okay, right. Okay, so we have some milestones, and when we announced this, I didn't realize that there would be so many milestones. But anyway, it's wonderful and it's great, and we just want to show some love and appreciation to the milestone birthday celebrants. Okay, there's a young man. Is he here today, by the way? Okay, he's hiding. Okay. There's a young man here who will be celebrating his 18th birthday. It's a milestone. On the 10th of April, he'll be legally an adult man. This young man is well-mannered. He is respectful and has a calm nature. He has matured nicely. He has grown into a fine, handsome young man. He is intelligent and has achieved all 8 GCSE subjects, including distinction. Hold on, there's more. He is a third Dan black belt in Taekwondo, which is a third level black belt, so don't mess with him. And he is at instructor level. He enjoys listening to a wide genre of music. He has been practicing playing the guitar and enjoys engaging with the House of Bread worship team. We've seen him here. His father says his son is his spitting image and he is his mother's favorite son. His big sister is his role model and she loves him dearly. This young man is ambitious, who is focused, analytical, and very affectionate. We, the Church of House of Bread, thank God for this young man's life. In the book of Jeremiah, it says, God says, I know the plans I have for you, to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. May the Lord bless you. Brother Darren, can you please come and collect your card? Let's just put our hands together for you.
Woo-hoo-hoo!
And let's just give you for this wonderful young man.
Yee!
This is a young man.
Yes! Come, Darren. Come, Brother Darren.
Woo! Okay, we have another milestone. Be quick. This brother will be celebrating his milestone birthday on the 10th of April. He will be 60 years old. Let me tell you a little bit about this brother. Over the years, this brother has served this local church as an usher. He is a humble man and is helpful to others, and he likes to encourage others. He always has a smile on his face. He is funny, and he likes to make others laugh and cheer them up. He has a YouTube channel called Royal Reasons. It's interesting. He is creative and resourceful. Does anyone remember the Grace Thriller CDs? That's how I became aware of Grace Thrillers. I had no idea until I met this man. This brother used to sing solo occasionally up here on the church roster many years ago. Do you remember that? And it was a real blessing. And it would be lovely to see him do that again one day. So today we give God thanks for his life and pray the Lord will continue to bless him with health and strength and many more days. Church, let's put our hands together for Brother Barry Royal.
Yes! Woo! Come, Barry, come!
Brother Royal, this is from our senior pastor, co-pastor, and all the members. God bless you. May you have a wonderful birthday. May the Lord bless you later. I think it'd be great for Brother Royal to sing at some point in the church again, one more time, but not just today. But it's wonderful to celebrate his birthday. Now we have one more. Now, wow. This lovely lady will be celebrating her 60th birthday on the 10th of April. This sister is glamorous and fabulous. She has the most infectious laugh and beautiful smile. She is friendly and talks to everyone. She's described as a willing soul who is happy to help wherever she can. She's also an evangelist. She reaches out to everyone. Her neighbors all know her on her road. In fact, I think she's probably known to everybody in New Cross. She is a cell group leader and her cell group loves her and respects her. This beautiful soul is a good listener and is caring. She is known to call up the cell group members and ask them to pray for anyone who is unwell or going through something. This lady is always jovial, but believe me, she has some powerful testimonies of how God has come through for her countless times. Her experience has undoubtedly strengthened her faith in God. She is a loving mother, grandmother, sister, and friend. This fabulous lady is a real joy to be around today. Church, let us just be thankful to God for her life and pray that the Lord grant her many more days. Church, let's put our hands together for none other than the fabulous Sister Marva.
Yeah!
Sorry, just one second. No, I am truly grateful to God. You know, no, seriously. No, I've been through some things, and at one point they thought I was going to be here, but to God be the glory. I'm 60 on Wednesday. Praise the Lord.
Thank you. God bless you. That's a card from the pastors and the House of Bread members, and we just pray that you have a wonderful day. And so for all the birthday celebrants, we'd just like you to stand so we can quickly just sing one round of happy birthdays. So Sister Jenny, if you could please raise that for me.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. We praise the Lord for another year. Happy birthday to you. God has been good to you.
To your neighbor and just give a smile. Praise God. God is good. Praise God. I'd just like you to just bear in mind, continue to pray one for another. Thank you, praise and worship team. God bless you. And I'd like to take this privilege to just greet our senior pastor, Pastor Cleveland Perkins, co-pastor, Pastor Poseda Perkins, Langley-Perkins, all God's people. If you're saved or you're unsaved, you're all God's people. Praise God. And those, I extend it to those that are online. God bless you and thank you for joining us week after week. Praise God. We are going to go into a time of prayer, and I want the men to be prepared, prepare your mind to go into this time of prayer. Our theme is, it's time for change. Amen. And I'm going to call on you just after Sister Patricia will be coming forward. Sister Patricia McKenzie will be coming forward, and I want the men to prepare your mind. as we are going into a time of prayer, I'm going to ask the men to come to the altar, join together, and we are going to be praying. I ask the men to pray. Sister Pat, you can come.
Greetings, church. Greetings, Pastor. I've asked Pastor Perkins to give me 5 minutes just to say thank you. Because I know that a few weeks ago you've prayed for us. And also, I think it's important to give you a background of what you've prayed for. My dad, many years ago, was diagnosed with prostate cancer. And maybe about 15, 16 years, because I was on maternity leave then. Treatment has gone on well over the 16 years, but it's now progressed. And since September last year, he was feeling discomfort, pains, nauseated, different things. And his PSA was really high. And he had stopped eating. And December, they went back to the GP. PSA doubled again. And the doctor basically told my mama, that she was losing him. Moving forward now. So I've decided to go home and spend some time. So I spent 4 weeks with him. And just before I left, 3 weeks ago, they went back to the doctor again, and nothing hadn't changed. So basically right now, he's at the end of life. So he's comfortable at the moment. He's still not eating. Drinks when he feels like. And he's not in any discomfort. He's pain-free at the moment. But I stand here to say thank you to all those who prayed and those who continue to have us in your prayers. Because when I listen to my mother saying that she's got 5 sisters and 4 of them are nurses, and she didn't choose that profession because she didn't want to be a carer, it did break my heart, because at some point she may be caring for him. At the moment, he's still able to help himself. He washed himself, feeds himself. But it was heartbreaking to see my father lying there. He's just bones. It was heartbreaking. And he's gonna be 86 in May. And what I've shared with my siblings was that I believe that God is gonna spare his life to see 86, and he's just gonna sleep away. But God is God, and my father is saved. He was baptized in 2012, but it's not easy. When I touched his gray hair, silky hair, to say goodbye, I know that that was goodbye. I know I won't see him again. But church, continue to pray for us and remember my mother. Most of you met her when she was here a few times and she had the opportunity to hold a mic. Sister Amy, I'm not sure if you're listening, but she appreciates your calls. Thank you, church.
Thank you, Lord. We're going to be praying, and I'm going to ask all the men that are safe. I'm going to ask you to come to the altar. I'm going to ask you to do a prayer for us. James 5, verse 17, it tells us about a man called Elias, Greek name, that is, what is Elijah. And the Bible said that he was a man like all of you men that are here today. And he said he prayed earnestly to God, and God heard, God answered prayer. And there are so many things that are happening today in our world, and our theme is, it's time for change. I'm going to ask the musician to come at the altar. All the men, the ushers, and we are going to be praying. Men, we can pray. Women know to travail. But men, when you pray, something happened. He tells us about Elias when he prayed. The men in the Bible, when they prayed, something happened. Men are powerful and you are stronger together. But in the name of Jesus, we are praying for that change. We are praying for a shifting. We are praying for a transition. We are praying that God will turn things around. We need that in the name of Jesus. Men, you're going to take your position. You're going to take your stand. And you're going to pray. The writer said, when the saints begin to pray, then the Lord will have his way. And the glory of the Lord will come down. Praise God. Wherever you are, if you are saved, I want men, you come to the altar right now. And you're in troubled water. And I want you to pray until you pray. What are you going to be praying about? Yeah, we're talking about change. You have your personal life that you need to change sometime. I need to change my life. But I'm speaking to the men of the house. Men that are listening to me right now, I'm speaking to you. You need to change. We need to change. So we are going to pray that God will change up some situation. Elias prayed and God heard and God answered him. Men, you all start to pray right now in the name of Jesus. Sisters, I want you to back them up in prayer. Men, start to pray. God bless you.
Transform, reposition, oh God, the men of this house, the men in this world, the men in society, the men in leadership, the men that are weird, the men, oh God, that needs you, God. We're praying today in the name of Jesus for men that are leaders, that they will stand up to their responsibilities in their home, in their community, in this society. In the name of Jesus today, we put them all before you. Put them all in your hand. And we ask God that you will speak to their hearts. Comfort their hearts, God. Turn their hearts towards you, God. Oh, God. Men are dying in sin. Many are lost. But in the name of Jesus, we pray, God, that God, your love for us will not be in vain, but for a turn in the name of Jesus that will turn towards you, God. And we'll exalt, we'll lift you up, we'll glorify you, God. We thank you, God, that you hear us. And we thank you that you answer us for you today. So we give you thanks right now. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, God. Yes, Lord. Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Right Jesus, 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 oh Jesus, right now, God, my God, Jesus, right now, God, thank you, God, thank you, Jesus, oh Jesus, 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 hear us now, God, hear us today, God, hear our cry, God, hear us today. Oh God. Oh God, yes, Jesus. Oh Jesus. Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Praise God, praise God, praise God, praise God. Thank you, man. Thank you, thank you, thank you. God is good. God is good. Praise God. I want us to also remember those who are sick. Sister Mighty is in the hospital. Sister Grant is still in the hospital. And Brother Thompson is in the hospital. And for those that were, I'm not aware of, but we pray one for another that we may be healed. You said effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. So we're going to continue to pray. We're going to be having worship and giving at this time. We're going to call praise and worship to come forward and get your offering ready. Ushers, could you get the receptacles? Praise God. And just have a prayerful heart, brethren. Praise God.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
Come all you weary, come all you thirsty, come to the well that never runs dry. Drink of the waters, come and thirst no more. Come all ye sinners, come on his mercy. Come to the table, he will satisfy. Oh,
waiting on Brother Silburn. He'll be coming to share with us for a few minutes.
Praise God! Praise God! From whom all blessings flow. Praise Him! Praise Him! For the wonders of His love.
Praise God! Praise God!
Praise God!
It's a time for change. Mm-hmm. To change, we have to change. And we have to do something to change. You'd think I know to use a microphone by now, wouldn't you? In 2 Chronicles 7, verse 14, it says, "If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land." We have to do something if we want to change. I'm not that young, so I had to write some little things down. We can program our mind. It is possible. God gives us the ability to program our mind. If we want to change, we have no excuse. We can map your ambition, become a risk taker, be willing to take a chance. Don't be afraid to take a chance. God has got you back. He said, "I know the plans that I have for you." When it said, "I," who are we talking about? When he said, "I," who's the "I" there? God Himself. He said, "I know the plans that I have for you." So don't get upset when people talk about you or try to put you down. They're not God. He said, "I know the plans that I have for you." When they're trying to put you down and talk about it, it's none of your business. God is on your side. Listen to this. "Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee, whether thou goest." Isn't that what? He said that to Joshua. He's saying that to you too. Listen to this. This is fantastic. Time is ticking. Pursue your dream now. January, February, March, where are they? They've gone. Please do not waste 2024, because January, February, March, it's gone. So pursue your dreams. Don't be afraid to think big. Dream big. Have huge gold. God will not give you the goal and the dream inside of you if it would not possible to achieve them. Glory to God. and act like you're definitely successful. Look at this, look at this, look at this. A little thing here. Have you seen one of these? You know what that? Here it is, yes. You're walking down the road, and this is what you see. They bump into someone, they don't see you. So, the University of YouTube is there. So change your mind. Whatever you're looking at, make it be possible. And positive thinking. There's so much there that you can use to be a better person and to change your life. Preacher's coming, I'm not preaching. God bless you.
God bless you, God bless you. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, God bless you. God bless you, Brother Silburn. Praise God. Praise God. We are going to get into the word or more of the word. Praise God. Let us just continue to pray for men. Just pray them up in a prayer that they will, you know, they will go higher and deeper in God. Because it's good to hear for them, knowing the time that we are living in. It's as if men are taking, slowly, like they are disappearing. But we pray in the name of Jesus. The Bible tells us that we are more than conquerors. And we want the men to be men in the name of Jesus. We are going into the word of God right now. I'm going to ask everyone to stand. And we're going to be praying for a preacher. Pastor Poseda will be coming forward to just give us the word. And I pray in the name of Jesus. Pastor, could you just come? Father, I come before you right now. I give you thanks. I give you praise. Because there is none like you. Lord, we thank you for thus far, for your manifold blessings upon our life. And, oh God, as your servants stand before you right now, God, I pray in the name of Jesus that, God, as you open, oh God, our vocal cord, oh God, there would be none of her but all of you right now. I pray, God, it may saturate, oh God, the scene, that every ear that have ear to ear, in the name of Jesus, they will hear your word. We thank you for this moment, and we thank you for your word in advance. Lord, that all that is going to minister to, all needs will be met in the name of Jesus. And we just want to tell you thanks in advance, in Jesus' name, amen and amen.
God bless you. Thank you, Sister Maxine. I'd like to greet you all in the worthy name of Jesus. I'd like to greet those of you who are watching online, and also greet you in Jesus' name. Praise God. I'm here to deliver the word today, and as I come in, as usual, the worship team is so in sync with where my heart was and where God led me. And I have prayed and I have prepared, and the Lord has put something on my heart, and I wish to share with you today. And I know you are praying for me. One of the scriptures that you used, Brother Silburn, was sent to me this morning. I thank God. I thank God. So I'm going to be looking at St. Mark chapter 16 from 1 to 20. And I'll read. Can we stand? And if it's projected, can we all stand to the reading of the Word of God? And this text influences what I have to say today. It's the Word of God. And I'll just read. And when the Sabbath was past, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, And Salome had brought sweet spices that they might come and anoint him. And very early in the morning, the first day of the week, they came unto sepulchre at the rising of the sun. And they said among themselves, who shall roll away the stone from the door of the sepulchre? And when they looked, they saw that the stone was rolled away, for it was very great. And entering into the sepulchre, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, clothed in a long white garment, and they were affrighted. And he saith unto them, be not affrighted, ye seek Jesus of Nazareth, which was crucified. He is risen, he is not here. Behold the place where they laid him. But go your way, tell his disciples and Peter that he goeth before you into Galilee. There shall ye see him, as he saith unto you. And they went out quickly and fled from the sepulchre, for they trembled and were amazed. Neither said they anything to any man, for they were afraid. And when Jesus was risen early the first day of the week, he appeared first to Mary Magdalene, out of whom he had cast seven devils. And she went and told them that had been with him, as they mourned and wept. And they, when they had heard that he was alive and had been seen of her, believed not. After that he appeared in another form unto two of them, as they walked and went into the country. And they went and told it unto the residue, neither believed they them. Afterward he appeared unto the 11, as they sat at meat, and upbraided them with their unbelief and hardness of heart, because they believed not them which had seen him after he was risen. And he said unto them, go ye into all the world, and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. So then after the Lord had spoken unto them, he was received up into heaven, and sat on the right hand of God. And they went forth and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the word with signs following. Can we sit with a praise? It was last week that we culminate this celebration. One of the most important events in the Christian calendar. The death, burial, and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. And the world would fill the churches. The world would go and fast. They would deny certain things, because it is this great event that the world celebrated. And nothing is wrong with that. It is a sign and a witness to them. And they have no excuse. Amen? No excuse. Man have no excuse to serve God, because there is that general revelation, that special revelation, the creation. And the events that happen in the world testifies that there is a God. And the church preached the gospel. And thank God, as Brother Silburn speaks of YouTube, technology, social media, It has its great advantages and its disadvantages, but you choose how you use it. Because technology is allowing the gospel to reach to every corner, to every ends of the earth. And the Bible said one of the signs when the gospel would have reached to the very ends of the earth, then shall the end come. And when we observe and know, we know that we are living in the last days. We are living in the end times. And the spirit of the age is upon us. It's in society. It's in our country. It's in the culture. And it seeps in the church. If we open the door and allow the ruler of darkness to come in, he will come in. If we open the door and allow, he will influence the church. He will, because we are the church. But if we shut the door, then he cannot come in. And so we look at the theme today, and every man given the opportunity to speak will take it from any different angles. But I was still thinking of the resurrection power of Jesus and what it means to you and I. And I hope that as I finish speaking to you, that whatever I share will cause us to look in ourselves. And if we're not going the way that we ought to go, if we're not doing the will of God, if we're not intentional and deliberate enough and using what God has placed into us to do his will, then we will change. Praise God. Praise God. Why is it necessary to change? Because the way we are at this time, we need different dimensions. We need to grow. We need to drop things and we need to move on. We need to make decisions as the church. And I just want to reinforce what we have been meditating on, preaching on, and looking on over the past weeks. Can you praise God with me? Through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, life has triumphed over death. Good has triumphed over evil. Hope has triumphed over despair. The resurrection is a sign of God's great power. Nothing is too great for God to achieve. And this fact, church, must comfort us in difficulties. We must trust God. As we sang earlier, he's alive. Hallelujah. Jesus is alive. Can we praise him? Bless the Lord, he's alive. The resurrection is not just a one-off element to the Christian story. Amen? The resurrection is not just a feature of Christianity. The resurrection is the main event. The word tells us, for if in this life only we have hope, we would be of men most miserable. Because he lives, we can face tomorrow. Bless the Lord. The resurrection is the main event for me. The resurrection of Jesus Christ from the grave is the greatest event in history. It is the greatest major event. It is the greatest event in the reality of redemption. There are many great leaders and so-called prophets. But when you check their grave, you can find their remains. Jesus laid, literally, he's not there. The resurrection is the cornerstone of the promises that we stand on in the gospel. It is that hope that we have that one day, this mortal shall put on immortality. We shall all rise to meet him. The dead in Christ shall rise first. Those that are alive and remain will be caught up to meet him. And in that great day, the whole world will see him. We speak of artificial intelligence. We speak of technology. We speak of where the world is going. I wish to submit to you that the stage is being set for his coming. We shall see him in his glory. Am I saying something to you that will cause you to rejoice? Because the resurrection is our primary theme of worship and praise. It is the source of eternal life for believers. Without the resurrection, without the cross, without the death of Christ, our lives as Christians would be meaningless. Without the resurrection, the cross would be powerless. If Christ is not raised, then our faith would be worthless, and we would still be in our sins. If Christ is not raised, the resurrection is just a little postscript. It is not a postscript. It is not an appendix in the footnotes in our Bible. The resurrection is sure. It is the climactic high point of the work of Jesus Christ. It is a story of redemption. It is the purpose of God to save his people. The resurrection is the major theme in the New Testament. When we look at the four Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, the Gospels were written by four different people, and it was written from their own point of view. Some give the gospel to the Jews, to the Gentiles, and those of you Bible study would know from which viewpoints the gospels were written. Mark, the gospel of Mark, as I listened and researched, he set out to prove a point that Jesus Christ was and is the Son of God. He proved his point, and that was it. But what I want to say, that though it was written by different people from their own viewpoint, by the power of the Holy Ghost, by the power of God, the Gospels were perfectly blended together, perfectly accurate and inerrant, a seamless story, every point fitting with every other point written from their own viewpoint. Isn't that amazing? And so it is proven that the resurrection is real. When we look at Mark 16, 14 to 20, Jesus, after being resurrected, appeared, which is a proof unto the 11 as they sat.
And he upbraided with them about their unbelief and hardness of heart. Because though many witnesses went to them, they did not believe. But I am sure as I follow on in the scripture, that after he spoke to them and bring things to their remembrance, they believed and they experienced that change that they were being prepared for. They turned the world upside down. And until today, the Holy Spirit and the gospel of Jesus Christ is turning man's life upside down, changing our world and turning our world around. When we read the Gospels, it speaks, and we're looking at Acts, the book of Acts in Bible studies. And last Thursday, we were amazed at the life, the great witness, the first martyr of Stephen. How Stephen, being full of the Holy Ghost, was able to preach. And he saw in the heavens, the word of God said. He said, I see Jesus standing at the Father's right hand. That caused his death, but that set the pace for us that are dead to sin, dead to this world, and alive to Jesus. He may not ask of us today to be a martyr for him, but he's asking us to be changed by the gospel, by the word of God. Brother Silburn was helping me, you know. Change is a choice to serve God and to do the will of God. Those disciples were changed, all right. They served God and they did not care for their life. Some of those who were martyrs, they said, I'm not worthy to be crucified upright like the master. Turn me the other way, upside down. And in Jesus' ministry, they were always overwhelmed. They were always filled with wonder and amaze. And yes, at times afraid. And at times unbelieving. And if you really look in the scriptures, you would feel that way sometimes. And you would understand why they felt like that. We are here. And if you are walking with a leader and you see him raise the dead, wouldn't you be afraid? Wouldn't you be trembling? Wouldn't you be amazed? They saw the dead raised. Mary Magdalene, 7 devils, demons were cast out of her. Jesus cast out demons. He healed the blind, the deaf, the dumb. The lepers were cleansed. He healed that woman with an issue of blood, 12 years. And he spoke to the nature around him. He spoke to the winds and the waves. And they said, what manner of man is this? And this is the present life we are living. Let us not get desensitized, church, by the word of God and by the gospel. But let us be reading the word. Let us be studying the word. Let us be praying. And let the Holy Spirit begin to deal with us and to stir us for the change that he needs. He said, I know the thoughts I think towards you. Everything is in sync today. I know the plans I have towards you, say the Lord. The purpose that he has placed in your life. Paul said, what shall separate us from the love of God? When trouble comes? when tests of life come? No, we have to go through the storms. We have to go through the trials. We have to go through the test of life and trust God. Trust God that He will see us through. How do we relate to our Christian faith? We're talking about a time for a change. If we are not in the place where we need change, then all right. Upwards and onwards. Carry on. There need to be a change that we not become event Christians. We will not be like the world, but that our faith and our Christian walk be a way of life for us. In our actions, in our attitudes, and in our deeds, we must be faithful. In our prayer life, in our times of Bible study, and also we must not be selfish, but look to the world around us and be the change agent. Because the creation waits with earnest expectations for the manifestation of the sons of God. The disciples heard the gospel and they were changed. And they change the world around them. Are we going to continue to sit in our padded pews and just be Sunday morning Christians only? I'm asking the question. I'm judging no one. We are His hands and His feet in the community. We must always be propelled to prayer, to Bible studies, giving to the poor and the needy in our very families, among our friends, among our neighbors, and in our community. That is what we are called to do. When the rich young ruler came to Jesus and he asked, "What must I do?" He said, "Go and sell all your goods and give to the poor." He went away very sad, because he held on to the things that he have and would not part with them. God is calling us for a change. God is calling us to be visiting the prisons. God is calling us to look after the sick, be caring for those who are sick, those who are bereft, those who are sad, the hurting ones in our family, the hurting ones in our friendship group, the hurting ones in our workplace, the hurting ones around us, our neighborhood. We must have thoughts to our neighborhood, to the families beside you, and they must always be in your prayer life. When you start to pray for the road you live on, I pray for the road I live on, every home. And I notice the minute I step out my front door, I'm attending to the rubbish bin or I'm sweeping up. Everybody pass, they call to me, because there's a spiritual attachment from me to them. Yes, I get to talk to them. I get avenues where I can share. They share with me. Because I pray for them. I break addictions on a Friday night. Alcoholism, domestic violence. Come on, church people. Change your lifestyle to affect. It is the way we think, you know. No one is asking you to go with tracts and handouts. No one is asking you to knock on a door and hand out tracts. The method doesn't matter. God Holy Spirit will speak to you and tell you what to do. Put ideas in you. My God, my God. I'm speaking to you today, church. And we're speaking from the standpoint of the resurrection and what it means to us. How the disciples were affected. How they were changed and turned around. And we are being asked to change. Our black boys are being killed on the streets. Is it just a news item to us? What can we do about it? As I was preparing, I remember coming into this country and being in a train. And there were so many people coming on the train. So many people. And I looked in London and someone said to me, they're having a great big festival and everyone is going there. Can I tell you about that festival that I found out? And so I looked it up. Witchcraft International, the largest witchcraft festival in the world, returns to Fairfield's Hall in Croydon on the 18th November 2023. Witchfest features up to 5 talks, workshop each hour, rolling every hour, with subjects on a wide range of witchcraft, Wiccan, pagan, heathenry, occult, and mythological subjects. Every hour, the festival is held where the psychics, the medium, the witches, the warlocks meet. Where did I say they meet? Where is that? The occult is practiced. And I dare say in its practices, blood sacrifices are being made. Look at the areas of knife crime. Look at the areas on our street where the blood of young boys, men, the head of the house, men who should lead the house, men who should have their families and raise godly families, men who should be the joy of their mother, their grandmother, boys who have finished high school with 9 or so GCSEs, all distinctions. I've been at a funeral here, 10 GCSEs. The funeral was here where the mother called out in her tribute for revenge. She said, I will not forgive. And she called out to the gangs around for revenge. I was at this funeral here. There were police around in plain clothes. There were more than 1 gang fractions represented here. A young man who had turned his life around and then got killed on the street. Look at the area of where the blood of men are being spilled. And consider the festivals. Consider the curse. Consider what is happening. Blood, call for blood. You might not like this, but it's reality. Just consider this, church. When Elijah prayed over the altar, he said, pour water on the altar. All the pagans call out for their God. Elijah mocked them. And then he prayed to his God and fire came. We must be praying. We must march those areas, get the church together and walk those areas and pray. Tear down the altars. Tear down the altars. What are you doing some nights watching TV until the wee hours of the morning? I'm not judging. I'm just asking. Where's your prayer life? Mothers, where's your heart for the boys that are not yours? Where's the comfort of the church to these families? I'm just talking about ways that we can change and we can begin to do the will of God. Because our children are spilling each other blood on the streets. We should be in earnest prayer. I'm talking what I know about. Because as I reflect and I prayed and I looked on the scriptures, I remember a time in Jamaica when there was a group of young people called Youth Life Team. I had just finished Bible school and was taught that small groups are powerful. Went back to my local church and I was given that group to grow. I've never been the leader before. I just read what it's about and I gather the group together. We announced it and about 50 young people come together. But I was told that it will whittle down to the number that will work. We got books and the training began. And then the ministry of them began. And we were young. We were naive. We didn't understand the world. But we took the word of God and the Bible literally. And that's why he said, young man, I call unto you because you are strong. We worked. Our lives was never the same. We read, we understood, we go to workshops. I'm telling you what we did. I'm telling you what we did. In the Maxfield Avenue area. I lived on the boulevard, Kingston 20, uptown. But everybody from uptown went down to Kingston 13. That was where that great church was and still is. Our youth department was over 115 numbers. And I remember my young days, we spent it on the street. We literally would hold hands and we would stand on the promises of God. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And lo, I am with you always. And we held hands and we said, God, you said you are with us. As we go, send your angels with us. We were on fire. I'm not lying. We march around every barnyard and shout them down. We march every lodge house, every secret societies. We march against them. We march around a place where it was just a place of bush. When we finished marching and praying, a madman came out of it and stand like that. And we said, Jesus said, loose him and let him go. And we prayed. We saw signs and wonders. Gunmen came to Christ. We go to the bars. We didn't have much sense. We were young people. And we stood at the bar doors and we prayed. I remember a big man got up out of the bar and came out crying into the waiting arms of young men. Young men who were once incarcerated, being on the street, delivered, and have turned witness for Jesus Christ. That community was under siege. The senior pastor called me one day. We didn't understand that when we finish and we go to one poor young girl house and eat out everything she may have had for the whole week. We didn't realize we were doing that. Yeah? And the pastor in his wisdom called and said, Poseda, are you guys planning to be on the street today after church? Yes, sir. I'm going to prepare food for you. Because he has wisdom. We didn't have that much. And that poor sister could get to save her food for the week ahead. Gunmen came to Christ. That local church never used to baptize the men in the community. That church never used to bury the gunmen around. But when God took a hold of that church, one young man, I remember him until today. He was running from the police and he picked up 5 shots in his back. didn't have a chance. You run, you get shot, whether you're guilty or innocent. And we understood he had 5 girls pregnant, and the church took them on. I'm just talking about changes that we can do. We were trained, we were prepared. We took to prison ministries. When they had riots in the general penitentiary and we go and we couldn't get in, we formed a barrier across the prison and we prayed. Every Sunday until they call us up to the penthouse where they had the mic to address the prisoners, they say, use this. So the microphone addressed the entire general penitentiary and they said, you have 15 minutes. We preach, we sang, we give the altar call in 15 minutes. Matthew 28, 18 to 20 said, and Jesus came and spake unto them, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. We pray down every unholy altars. Raise up the community. My God, we witness for Jesus. We witness for Jesus. And I'm saying to you, church, I'm not speaking to you of what I have not experienced and have been growing by. I remember, and I'm coming down. I remember they told us that there was a woman in one of the community who would come out ever so often, periodically, and warn the community. I don't know if you know what that means. Do her hocus pocus and her everything and warn the community. And they said to us, when she come out, we are fearful because people are going to die. They became fearful and so they go to the woman for protection. And I believe in all hearts that she was a witch. They had their rings, their guard rings loaded, witchcraft, and seemingly for protection against being killed. The community was under the power of darkness. They said as gunmen, when the police was coming, the ring would burn them. And we knew it was not right. Because when one young man got saved under the power of the Holy Ghost, we went to camp and he was saying, it's burning, it's burning. We took it off. He said, he nearly killed us. He said, I'm left vulnerable. It is 7 of them and they protect me. And we teach him. He was healed, he was delivered. So I want to say to you, brethren, church, it's not going out on the street and handing out tracts. Where in the community can we start a Bible study? Which group of people is God sending us to? Which group of women? Which group of men? I count 24, 25 men coming up to the altar this morning to pray. Which group of boys can we minister to? Which group of girls can we minister to? Is God sending us to a group of foreigners in this country? A group of refugees maybe that don't look like us? Which institution is God sending us to? When we begin to pray, this church and groups, cell groups, can adopt so many areas of ministry. Which mission is God placing on your heart? What about your neighbors? All power is given unto me in heaven and earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all truths. We have the word, and we know the Bible is coming out of us. We sit in here, but the charge for us is to be changed. Every day we use Chronicles, if my people who are called by my name humble themselves. But God is saying, turn to the harvest. Turn to those around you. Turn, that is Jesus' commission. As Christians, that's what he said to the disciples. And that is what he's saying to us. I must say, cell group from, is it Bellingham? With the coats. Every day a prayer go up for that group who gave out those coats in winter. Every day a prayer goes up. God is calling us to turn. God is calling us to do his will. God is calling us for a change. We are the change. We may have other agendas. We may be thinking different things. But this is the change. The resurrection power tells it all. And from that background, we can go and we can do. Church, I'd like you to stand, please. And I'd like you, if you could move forward. It's okay. Move forward. And we're going to pray. Worship team, I could call you to sing, Lord, I'm available to you, but I won't. Stand where you are and pray that God will send you somewhere to worship in a strange area. Just an hour of your time, just to worship. Cell groups, where is God sending you? Church, where is God sending you? There are many issues we have, but God is able to handle it. God is able to deal with it. Let us not just look to young people and say, oh, young people, we want to see them doing this and that. Let us catch fire and turn and let them see us burn. Let us be on fire so we can pass the baton on. Let us worship that they can see worship and want to have that fire. Where we are bruised and torn and not worthy, God, let us trust God to fix us. Let us trust God to turn us around. Let us trust God to put us right. But what is very important, let us change to do the will of God. Let us all pray together and ask God to prepare us, to speak to us, that we will do his will. If you want to come to the altar and you want to pray for the families of those boys who are being knifed down, if you want to pray for a change in our community, a change that the news will show where the knife crime is non-existent, we can pray for that. We can pray for the pain of mothers, of sisters. Girls are being knifed as well. When I watched the news and I saw that beautiful girl, I cried. Where is the anger coming from? Where is it that you have an argument and it's the knife? In Jamaica, it's the gun. In America, it's the gun. A young child will be upset and just go back to the school and everyone is dead. But in this Lewisham, the borough of Lewisham, let the church make a difference right where we are. Everyone, begin to pray. Begin to pray to God. Pray for someone today. Pray that you will be the change of comfort, of encouragement. You will be the change because you're God's child. You're a disciple. Touch us, Lord. Change us, God. Change us, Father. There are many arguments around this, Father. Many arguments, Father. But just touch us, because you have all wisdom. You have all power. Sister Judene, if you would lead this prayer.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you for your words. Thank you, Lord God, for speaking to us, Lord God, and reminding us, Lord Jesus, that you have called us, you have saved us, and you've given us a work to do, Lord Jesus. But to do that work, Lord God, we need to be changed, Lord Jesus. We need to fall in love with you again, Lord Jesus. We need to do the first works. We need to be available, Lord Jesus. We need to make you our priority, Lord God. Father, in the name of Jesus, knowing the signs of the times are everywhere and the things that we're hearing, Lord God, sometimes, Lord God, we're becoming numb to all the things that we're hearing and we're seeing, Lord God. But Father, I pray, Lord God, that you will remove that desensitized that we have, Lord God, and make us very sensitive, Lord God, to what you want us to do, to who you are and who we are supposed to be. Prayerful people, Lord God, people that are not conformed to this world, Lord Jesus, people who are set apart and sanctified wholly for your use, Lord God, so that at the drop of a hat, Lord, we are ready, Lord Jesus, to address what we are seeing around about us and in our own families, Lord Jesus. To stand up, Lord God, for Jesus, Lord God, wherever we are, wherever we go, Lord God. To not be silent, not to be apathetic, Lord Jesus, but to be willing, Lord God, to speak for you, to do your will, to be your hands and your feet, Lord God. Father God, I just pray that you'll help us, Lord God, to disengage from all the distractions and all the things that don't really, really matter, Lord God, and re-engage with you and the work that you've called us to do, Lord God. Hallelujah, Father God. Hallelujah. Father, that we will work for you, that we will live for you and we will work for you, Lord God. Open our eyes, Lord Jesus, to what is happening all around us. And let us be ready, Lord God, to pray and to read your word and to be filled with your word, filled with your spirit, Lord God, so that we can be useful to you in these days, in these last days, Lord God, that we will not be drawn away with the spirit of this age and we will not be deceived, Lord God, but we will be alert, we will be woke, we will be awake, Lord God, to do your will and your good purpose, Lord Jesus. In the precious name of Jesus, we pray, Lord God. Soften our hearts, Lord God. Hallelujah. Remove our stiff-neckedness, Lord Jesus. Father, we know we're living in a self-age, Lord God, where we're just thinking about ourselves all the time. But Lord God, let us put ourselves aside. You said if we come to you, we should lay down our lives and follow you. Take up our cross and follow you, Lord God. There's something that you want us to do, Lord God. There's somewhere you want us to go. Let us be willing, Lord God, to do your will, Lord, because that's all that really matters, Lord God, because all of this, you're going to roll it up one day and it's going to be finished. But Lord God, we want to be true to you, just like you're true to us. Help us to be true to you, Lord God. Revive, Lord God, the dead works. Revive the dead works amongst us, Lord God. Hallelujah. Neli lilu mai se warriago jo joira rago un selki de tiore guardia de piaramo su tania neli lu hama sei we no mo yisi we na mai sendas. Revive Lord God, revive us Lord again, Lord Jesus. Nei umai mama yisi wa mai kengor jala mai sias. Wake us up Lord God, let us not be deceived, not let us not be deceived. Hallelujah, Lord God. The harvest awaits us, Lord God. Let us not be too comfortable, Lord Jesus, that we don't do your work, Lord God. Wake us up, Lord Jesus. You said, woe to those who are at ease in Zion. Oh, yeah, woe to those who are at ease in Zion. You're coming soon, Lord God. Lord God, you said that we should be doers of the word and not hearers only deceiving ourselves. By your grace and your power, Lord God. Father God, forgive us, Lord Jesus. Forgive us for allowing the enemy to distract us from what you really want from us, Lord God, because we always want from you, Lord God, but you also have a requirement of us, Lord God. You didn't fill us to be stagnant. You didn't fill us to be complacent. You filled us so that we could do the work of the Spirit. Lord, and we repent today, Lord God. We repent, Lord Jesus, for allowing your Spirit to be dormant in us while the world around us is dying, Lord God. We repent. We repent, Lord Jesus, for putting ourselves before you, before your work, before your will, before your way. For putting our own agendas above your agenda. We repent. We repent, Lord God. We repent, Lord. We repent, Lord God. We repent, Lord Jesus, for being unloving and unforgiving, Lord God. We repent, Lord God, and we're asking you, Lord God, in your name, in the name of Jesus. Re-baptize us in your Spirit, Lord God, for your purpose.
not for our purpose, Lord God. We can't come to your house, Lord God, and do politics, Lord God. This is not the world, Lord God. This is not the world. This is not the workplace, Lord God. You said we should be different. We should be different. The kingdom of God is different from the world, Lord God. So we're asking you, Lord, have mercy on us. Forgive us and help us to change. Help us to be willing to change. Thank you, Chiamas. And as we take steps to change, oh God, may your spirit help us, Lord. Realign us with your plan. Realign us with your purpose for our own lives and for this local church, Lord God, which should be a beacon in this community, Lord God. Help us to understand, Lord God, that little Kiabasu Tiambaku Yiditiarutuso Pachinas, and that's that you want this place to thrive and you want your house to be filled. And you are poised and you are waiting for us, Lord God, to yield to you so that you can send in your harvest. Clean us up, Lord God. Wash us again, Lord God. Wash us again, Lord God. And heal this land. So that your will will be done. And help us to submit to your will, Lord God. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus that you will remove the spirit of rebellion from your house. Because we are supposed to be like children in your house. Remove the spirit, I ask in the name of Jesus. Lord God, that you will escort the spirit of rebellion and division and derision out of this house in the name of Jesus. By your spirit, Lord God, escort the spirit of disobedience and all the unclean spirits. Resident in this house, we uproot you from your seat in the name of Jesus, and we bind you and we cast you out so that the will of God can be done in the house of God. Because Lord, we have opened the door, and they have come in amongst us, Lord God, and they are spoiling your work, but in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we catch every thief, every spiritual thief, Lord God, in your house, and we bind that spirit now in the name of Jesus. And we ask, Lord, that you will escort them off of this property in the name of Jesus. And we draw a bloodline around this house of bread. Let the blood of Jesus that did not drop in vain, Lord God, cover this place and escort everything out, everything that has come to dwell amongst us, Lord God. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ that you will remove them and they will not be able to come back in. In the name of Jesus, we anoint every doorpost, every window, every threshold, every doorway, Lord, with the blood of Jesus Christ that was shed. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on your people. And lift up like a flood, lift up a standard against the forces of the enemy, because this house is your house. And Lord, we just submit ourselves to you. Let your spirit flow through this building, through our lives, Lord God. Clean us up, Lord. You're coming soon. You said you're coming for a church without spot or wrinkle. Lord, so let us be conscious. Lord God, wake up all the unconscious brethren, Lord God, amongst us. And anything that is unconscious, Lord God, amongst us, wake it up, Lord God, by your spirit. Even while we're sleeping, wake us up. The time is short and the harvest is ripe. In the name of Jesus, we seal this prayer with the blood of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Hallelujah. Amen.
Praise God. Romans 12, verse 1 said, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that he presents your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Praise God. Praise God. Is there a need for prayer? If there's a personal need, we're going to be closing, but I'd like to give you this opportunity. If you have not yet accepted Christ as your personal Savior, tomorrow is not promised to any of us. If you would like us to pray with you, would you come now? We're closing. Praise God. Church, could you stand? I'd like to just pronounce a benediction, a blessing over each life as you go through this week. I pray and I read from 2 Corinthians 13, verse 14. It said, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with you all. God bless you. Have a blessed week. And thanks for worshiping with us today. God bless you all. You are dismissed.